Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install FFmpeg on Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how to use FFmpeg. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. And if you are still facing any issues in the middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I am also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I am definitely going to help you. So now to install FFmpeg, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here FFmpeg download, hit enter. So that will show you this FFmpeg.org, so just simply go to their official site. So this link I am going to provide right in your description. Once when you are here, you will see that it is available for Linux, Windows and Mac OS, right? So, depending upon what operating system you use, you need to download their respective source file. So, for Windows, I'll just simply click on this and that will show you this Windows build from gan.dev and Windows build by btbn. So, I'll proceed with this btbn. So, I'll click on that and that will redirect to this GitHub page of FFmpeg builds. Here, you can see we have all these different builds available, right? So from here I'm going to download it for Windows. So this is this FFmpeg master latest win64 gpl shared.zip. So I'm going to just simply click on that and that going to immediately start downloading our FFmpeg package. So you can see it is rightly started downloading. So let's wait for a few seconds and you can see that it is rightly downloaded now. So just simply click on this icon so that will open it on our download directory. So here is our file. So just simply right click and just simply click on extract all and click on extract. So that will extract all of our files over here. You can always click on show more details. You can see this rightly started extracting and it is rightly done. Yeah, and it is also opened over here. I can close this. So here is our extracted folder. So if you go inside, you will get this folder again. If you go inside, you'll get all files and folders over here. So now what you need to do is, so this is the extracted folder, go inside, you need to right click and you need to click on show more options and to rename this, and you can rename to something very simple, something like only FFmpeg. All right, so rename that and then right click and cut this folder and go to our C drive and just simply paste it over here. That's it. So just download the package, extract it, rename it and just simply put it on our C drive. So if you go inside, you will get all these files. You will get a bin folder also. Go inside and now you have to click on this address bar and right click and copy this path and go to search and type environ. So that will show you this edit the system environment variables. Just click on that. That will open system properties window. Click on environment variable and click on path over here. Then click on edit. So that will open this edit environment variable window. So just simply click on new, right click and paste that FFmpeg/bin folder path over here. And just simply click on OK. Then again OK and then again OK. And now you know that your FFmpeg is rightly installed. You can also verify that. Let's minimize all this and just simply go to search and type cmd to open our command prompt. And within command prompt, if you just simply type FFmpeg in space dash version and just simply hit enter, you will get this type of prompt. So if you're getting this type of prompt, then all that basically means is your FFmpeg is rightly installed on your system. And now we are good to use FFmpeg. So I'm going to demonstrate that. So what I have done is I have created a video file which is actually an eMovie file. So you can also go to this details pane and when you click on the folder you can see all the details. So it is a 4K video actually, and 60 FPS is the frame rate and this is bit rate and all. And the file size is 601 MB, right? So it's a 4K video and file type is MOV. So you are going to convert it to a MP4 file and you also want both audio and video quality intact. So if I play this video, you can see that this is the video quality right now. So it's a very beautiful Phi Island in Thailand. So it's really beautiful. So quality you can see clearly over here. So I want it to be this exact same quality when it gets rendered output, right? So let's, you know, use our FFmpeg for that. Just click on this address bar and type cmd to open our command prompt right at this location, and then you need to run one command. So I have already prepared this command for you. I'm going to put this on our channel description also. So I'm going to copy it and I'm going to paste it over here, and I'm going to customize it as per my need. So you have a video file called fifi.mov. So I'm going to, you know, move my cursor to this input.mov, and I'm going to remove this input with our own file name, which is fifi. Alright, and it is a fifi.mov file, so I have given that properly, and all other things will be fine. You can give a customized output file name also. I'm going to give just a very simple output.mp4 file, and I'm just going to hit enter. So that's going to immediately start, you know, generating our output file. You can see output.mp4 is actually started generating. It's not created yet, it's still, you know, you can see the frame is increasing, so it is preparing our video. So it is converting. You can see the FPS speed also, 14-15 FPS and all that, and you can see the total size also coming over here along with the time, you know, time duration and the bit rate. You can see the speed also. And you can see that it is rightly done. So if you go back to your folder, you can see it has properly generated one output.mp4 file, and these are all the details. So you can see our file size is about 900 MB, and our frame width and height, it's remain intact, so it's still a 4K video. Frame rate is also same, bit rate, everything is fine. So if you play this video, so you are going to get that audio also. Everything is, you know, same to same, and you also got the output, and it's converted from MOV to MP4 file. So our quality is also intact. So yeah, so that's how you install latest version of MPEG and you start working on your own video projects. So that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I am posting lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. Along with, if you are interested on WordPress, you can always watch our WordPress videos. So all these videos are available on our channel for completely free. So don't forget to watch all these videos on our channel. So basically you can watch this entire playlist, and all these tutorial links I am going to provide on our channel description.